Hello friends, welcome to LabTechs. My name is Nasir. Along with me, Dildar sir is here. And today is the Dildar sir favorite case study, charging problem. And this case is really very outstanding, just because again and again the MOSFET is getting burnt and sometime it is blowing up, and there is something wrong with this motherboard. This is the motherboard Dell 3521, and the part number, as you can see, it is written here. This is the part number LA9104P, and now you can see that once I used this MOSFET here and sometime this MOSFET. Now you can see once as soon as I use this charger, this battery, what happened, it is sometime this one is blowing up and sometime this one. So this is the problem I have received. So I have changed once. So now everything is okay. I will show you that this types of problem you will also face, and charging problem, as you know, that we love charging problem, and it may be very much difficult for you because you have lack of theory. So you just go with our videos, inshallah you will get each and everything, every information from there. Now you see that something has gone again. You have seen that it is happening like this way. CC, the constant current is going up and the voltage is dropping. Now in this way, this is the power supply I am using here now. So as you have seen, once again you see that voltage is getting down and current is picking up. So it indicates you that the current consumption is rather than it's required. So and I'm damn sure that either of the MOSFET is blown up. So let's find out. So I think it is charged now. So let me discharge it. It will take time to discharge because the current is traveling inside the MOSFET. So it will take time to discharge. And after, and there is one also way, if I try to make it off like this way. I think this time I have lost this triple one. Okay, this is also beeping, this is also, and it is increasing now. Now you can see that after injecting power you should wait at least for a moment so that let the FET discharge its current, because the current is flowing. Then at that moment, if you are checking the impedance value, now you see that it has gone. So in this way, my this two MOSFET, upper drive and lower drive, is safe now. So this is the, so my discharging MOSFET, which is also known as the battery FET, it is also safe now. And this one is blown this time. So third time, this was just for your demonstration. I have sacrificed one MOSFET. So otherwise I never prefer to inject the battery inside the motherboard if there is any problem. But in order to show you only, I have sacrificed my this MOSFET. So let me remove this, and I have done one more thing in this motherboard, and I must tell you, as you know that we are not getting products from China, so there is a lack of ICs in the market. So in this motherboard there was the BQ, the charging IC was 747 BQ 24747. So I was not having that IC. So what I did, I used here Max 8831, and which is very compatible, but actually there are the something which auxiliary component you need to change in this motherboard. Now you can see the shorting is gone. So it is very sure that this MOSFET was short. One thing you have to remember, at the time checking shorting, you have to make sure that on the buzzer, if source to drain and source to gate and gate to drain, if you find any beeps on, it indicates you there is a shorting in the MOSFET. So 3 has gone. Now I will not use this battery. Maybe battery could be faulty, but I am damn sure that battery is okay. There is something problem with this motherboard. What I have done here, now you can see here. So here it was BQ24747, and I used here ISL88731C. Both are the same, as you can see in the diagram, as I would like to show you in the diagram. You can see that if I try to use instead of this IC, if I want to use this one, so what I need to do here, I need to change so many components nearby the charging IC. And this is the indication that for the ISL, it would be at the rate. It means it will not be put on the place. Instead, on the BQ24747, there must be 2 kilo ohm, 200 kilo ohm resistor on the PR122. So what is the very much complicated thing here, that in this particular motherboard there is no marking of the component, of particularly if you talk about resistor and capacitor. So in this case you need to have at least one scrap motherboard, so that you can easily access the component from the scrap motherboard, and you can fix it on its place as the required for the ISL88731. This is the very usual IC which you can find in any of the motherboard, but this is the very rare IC and hardly you will get in motherboard. So I was not having this one. So what I have done, I use instead of 24747, I used 88731. So here I have removed this resistor, like this pin number 13 is the ACOK. There was pulled up with 100 kilo ohm for the BQIC, but I am using ISL, so it requires divider, and the voltage supply is LDO, the VDD LDO which comes out from the charging IC, as we have described in the our video classes. There are the 12 hours video of charging IC. I'm sorry guys, if you ask for that the laptop is not getting charged, and tell me that what should I do, or the light is blinking sometimes, red light and green light and whatever the light glows, I cannot help you to fix the charging problem, just because it is almost impossible to crack the problem through the WhatsApp chat, through the call, because you can understand that we have described single charging IC at 12 hours. So at least if you have gone through all the charging IC concept, then only you can understand that what is the calculation of ILIM, like what is the calculation of every particular comparator, what is the calculation of bootstrap pin, what is the configurations pins, what is the functions area, what are the charging requirement area. When you are plugging and backup is not, the battery is not giving the backup, the what area you have to target. There are so many, you know, complicated problems you have to face at the time while you are repairing for the charging purpose any motherboard. You stuck up just because of lack of knowledge, because I am sure that those who has gone through our video classes, there we have described each and everything, the functional area, the requirement, the things I would like to show you with you. And I would like to share the information what we teach. So this is what we conduct in our classes, in our video classes. These are the area, this is a very common area, and through this the ACOK logic is decided, either it will be high logic or the low logic. So at this point I think we have described, or the Dildar sir has described very with a well manner. If you search the charging IC concept in the YouTube, you will find our BQ24, the same IC you will find out, BQ24 45 IC, that you will find out that Dildar sir has described around 45 minutes he has taken to describe only how you will get the AC OK logic. And rest of the things we haven't described because it is on the paid video. This is the area through this the charging matters. All the charging problem comes through these area as well as the SDN, SCL, and there are so many things which you have to check. But how you will check, this is inside the IC, but there is something pin which will indicate you that your charge will proceed or it will not. You can see that around 17 to 18 comparator, individual comparator has been given. You can also check the particular point through the auxiliary pins. So there are the various things combined, then consequently you get your laptop charge or your battery get charged. So this is quite impossible to say in a word through the WhatsApp that if your laptop is not getting charged, I cannot help you, sorry for that, because you can see that this is inside the charging IC. This is having merely 20 pin, and you can see that so many concepts is behind it. And if you try to find it, 43 pages has been given. If you are interested, you can go through this PDF file as well. Otherwise, if you just want to understand that what is the logic behind the charging, then you can contact on the given number and you can get the video. Now let's talk about this particular case, and I would like to demonstrate you what is the problem behind it. Now I have successfully changed, I have replaced the IC BQ into ISL. Now despite I am getting, however, the same situation I was getting, and I have changed this IC, but despite the same thing is occurring again and again. What should I do now? So let's open the schematic of this particular model Dell 3521. So this is the charging IC area, and you will always find that charging IC area is slightly complicated than other areas. So what is happening that sometime my battery FET, or you can say discharging FET, is blowing up, and sometime my switching FET is blocking. You can say it are RB FET, this is the AC FET and this is the RB FET. So either of one is definitely shorting whenever I am using the battery. What does it mean if you keep on changing? That is, that doesn't make any sense. What should do you now? So let's check this area, because high voltage is going through this area. If what does happen, why this thing is happening, sometime this is blowing up and sometime this one is blowing up, just because of this, the 12 volt is coming from here, the 12 volt and the 18 volt is coming from here. If both comes together, then high current is trying to pass out through this MOSFET as well as through this MOSFET, and it is causing to blow up either of the MOSFET. When this will happen, that both will try to move forward, like 12 volt try to enter in the 18 volt and 18 volt try to enter in the 12 volt area. This thing is command by this circuit. Here what we need to check here, that if we get on this, if I am not using the battery, if no battery, if I am using no battery section, then what we need to get here on this particular point, on this gate, I need to get here 20 volt, as it is connected with the VIN. And also you can see that the first MOSFET VIN is present here. Now here we must get 20 volt. If we do not get, then we can consider that any of the component is not functioning very well. Now let's come and check. So let's inject. I'm not using battery now. I will just check casually without battery. I will try to find that what is happening and what is the situation over here. So see, this is the PQ102. This is the PQ102. Let's check the gate. You are getting the 6 volt. However, you are unexpected to get 6 volt on this particular point. As you can see that the VIN area must function here. Either this 200 kilo ohm is blown up, and due to that the less voltage is passing through this, or what could happen here? The possibility I am telling you, because if you are repairing that, you need to understand the possibility. What could be the possible reason that you are getting the less volt on this point, however you are not using the battery? If you are using the DC jack, then definitely the VIN section will be working on this point, and after the VIN here also it must be 20 volt. If you are not getting 20 volt on this point, what would be happening? 200 kilo ohm is blown up and reduce the voltage, and it is switching on this PQ102, and as it is switching, the both voltage is coming together, it is bumping into, and it is blowing up this particular either of the FET. Or on the other aspect could be that this voltage is coming out V1, and what is the V1? Let's find out what is the V1. So if you copy it, just copy it, let's copy the V1 and find out where it is. I think it is the new name I have found, V1. So let's find, it's a V1. So here, what do you expect? When you are getting the DC in voltage, you are getting the AC in voltage, definitely you will be getting the AC, okay, high logic. And this high logic is going to the AC in, to becoming the AC in. Now you can see that the AC okay is transmitting into AC in. This AC okay is transmitting into AC in, and this AC in is coming here. And if it is a high logic 3.3 volt, it will switch on this MOSFET, and as well as it will switch on this MOSFET. If it will switch on, then you will get the voltage divider, and through this voltage divider it is going on the upside of the gate of the MOSFET. It will switch on. But what it will do, it is the production circuit. This is called the production circuit. This is also known as the OBP circuit. Okay, and what is the OBP circuit and how does it work, and there are so many more logics behind that. I just don't want to go into the so much deep, but only I want to tell you one thing so that you can also understand what is the case study. This AC1 will switch on this PQ114A, and the ground will go up, then 19 volt cannot pass through this resistor. It will stop on this point, and here 0 volt should come at any cost. Now let's come and check, it's the 0 volt here. I can write it is the 0 volt. Okay, then 0 volt cannot switch on this NPN BJT. This transistor cannot be switched on because of 0 volt on the base. Then we cannot expect that the ground will go upside. If it is going upside, then it is leakage. This is the thing you need to understand here. So if it is happening like this way, if you are getting the 0 volt, and despite you are getting the less voltage on this point, what is happening here, that it is, if the ground area is getting this voltage, if you are getting the ground on this point, VIN through this two resistor, it has become the voltage divider, and the divider voltage you are getting on this point, that will also switch on this MOSFET, and it will blow up either of the MOSFET. So there are so many possibilities behind this. So I will check one by one what is the causing of this again and again short of this particular MOSFET. Now let's come and find out that what is the problem inside the. So I will target, first of all I will target this PQ107. So since what is the wrong about this, we don't have the board view of this particular model, but the good thing that the PQ name is written, the capacitor and the resistor name is not mentioned in the board. So this is the PQ107, and let's check. I'm just checking, I don't know that which one is the base and which one is. Now let me inject the DC power. It is injected. Now let's check. Now you see that 3 point something volt is on one terminal, so I cannot expect that what is that. Let's see, this one is 0, this one is 0. First of all, try to find out which one is the ground. So this is the ground. So two pin, one pin would be base. So this is the ground, and one would be base and one would be collector. So you have to find the base at anyhow. So now there are the two resistance is given. Now what you have to do through the continuity mod, you have to find this one is connected and this one is connected with this one, and this one must be 19 volt as it is shown here. It must be 19 volt. I have connected it. This particular most resistor should be connected to the gate of this PQ102 as well as with the this resistor. You can easily find out through this with the help of continuity. Now you are checking this point, and this point must be connected with the gate of this. Now you can hear the beep sound, so it indicates me that this is being the voltage divider. So now we can conclude that this one is collector and this one is base. Now check, we should not get any voltage, as I was telling you, here should not be any voltage either from this point. Even this, from this point, VDD LDO will reduce this voltage also. Here we should not get any voltage, but we can expect anything could happen. If here is the 20 volt, then obviously it will be switch on and it will make it voltage divider. Now let's come and check. Here we should not get any voltage. We are not getting. Then why we are getting less voltage on this point, on this terminal? If we have not get the voltage on the base, it should not be switched on, and it is not switched on, then why we are getting the less voltage on this point? So definitely something is wrong with this on this particular point. Or what could be happened if you go in the deep, this could also be reason to reduce the voltage. But I have also changed this one. Then this area will define you that what is the problem. So do one thing, you just check manually that either any shorting in this point. You have no shorting from the any area. So what is it called? If no shorting, no any problem, no voltage on the base, but despite you are getting the less voltage, do one thing, remove it. Because on this resistor I am expected to get 20 volt while I am using my adapter. Now let it be slightly cool. Now let's check. Input 20 volt. Input VIN I'm checking 20 volt. Output of the resistor 20 volt, and output of the resistor 20 volt, and the collector. Now you can see. Now I have get 20 volt on this point. Now even you can check on this point here. The healthy condition of this motherboard should be like this way, 20 volt. So sometime what does happen, that the switching is something which as Dildar sir has described in the video courses, the BJT function, the MOSFET function and op-amp function, diode switching, Zener diode switching, each and everything he has described in the switching section. Now still I can say you that sometimes some critical case you can get, which really will become the albatross around your neck, and which will be really hard to find out the solution. But if you are very much deployed with your towards your logic analyzing, like as I am showing you that how I am going to analyze this one, you have seen that it was not short, you have seen that it is not getting voltage on the base, but despite I am expected here, if you have fixed the target that you are required of this particular voltage, then you can easily repair any problem. So I think it is done now, and what I need to do, I have to fix, because this is the major point. Maybe as soon as, one thing I would like to show you here, one more important thing, as I will remove the charger from the motherboard, here it will go 0 volt, and 0 volt will switch on the this particular MOSFET PQ102, and it will drive all the current to inside the motherboard. Through the sensing resistor, it will go into the motherboard. So that is why this particular point is also required to help that if anything goes wrong, it will just protect the board to blow up its any component. Now let me have my scrap motherboard, and as I have already taken out, so this is the my good iron hot air gun. I have to use from here. Now I think I have changed all things, all the wrong components, all the bad components, nasty components. Now let's come and make sure again. AC FET, RB FET, high drive and low drive, not short, and the battery FET or the discharging FET, there is no shorting at all. Now finally I am going to check it. Now I have changed this BJT, NPN BJT. Now check on the collector, 20 volt. As it was coming 3 volt, and that was the reason that it was getting 3 volt on this point, and that is why it was switched on, and high current is confronting together, 18 volt into 12 volt, and that was causing to blow up the MOSFET. Now I am going to inject the battery. Now finally 3 time I have changed the MOSFET, then I brought back my sense to find out the actual problem. I thought it would be very much easy. Now you can see that the charging is taking place. However, it will not charge just because I am not using ID. But even I was using this thing earlier, it was blowing up the MOSFET. So now what I need to do here, I need to use my adapter ID. This is my adapter ID. I have made it with a bad adapter, and I will use it, because as you know that the Dell and the HP will not charge without adapter ID. So my DC jack is not working, one of DC jack. I think this is the right. Now you will see that the charging light is glowing up, and now the ampere has increased. It indicates that the charging process is happening in this motherboard. Now I would like to show you through the DSO. You can also make it sure that the laptop is charging or not. Now let's come and see. This is the process. That one side you should get the PWM. I would like to show you here. I have turned the motherboard. Now one side I am checking here. Here I am getting high voltage. Let me reduce the voltage here. It is on the milli voltage. Let me set it on the 5 volt, and it is on the X10. So let me set it first. So it is on the test point. I am just press the auto button, and it will give me a basic setting. Now you can see that 11.3 volt I am getting, and this side I think something is gone wrong. Now you can see that the ampere has reduced. There is something problem with my adapter ID, because you know I keep on testing the motherboards with the help of this Acer lead, Now it will function very well. Now let me check once again. 11 volt you will get on the input side, sorry, output side. 11 volt you will get on the output side, and the input side you will get this way. Now you can press the auto. In order to measure that what is the frequency the charging IC is sending, 407 kilohertz. As you know that Dilraj sir has described in his video that the charging IC comes with the various frequency, like 750 kilohertz to other could be the differ. So here we can make sure that the charging process is happening, because the PWM is like this. PWM you will not see if I remove the battery. Now I'm going to remove the battery. You can also observe that you will not get anything on this point. Now you see. Okay, so I hope guys that you have loved this video, because as much was behind the logic I have described you, I have not hidden anything. I have bring forth for you all the information. All I want you to grow in the laptop repairing field. But this is quite natural phenomena that I cannot tell you each and everything briefly, because 250 hours video we have made for your convenience, so that you have not to make it to Delhi and you have to stay in hotel and you have to learn and you have to keep your office closed. That's why we have made the video, and we are providing you the new latest update. Like our new update is about to commence in October. There we are going to describe the new charging IC concept. We are going to describe over there the C-type concept. There we are going to describe the new BIOS communications. There are the various variety of things has come, like 6, 7, 8 generation PCH 200 series, 300 series has come. What is the new in that? We are going to describe in the latest update. Apart from that video, we are providing the latest update. So if you are interested in laptop repairing, if you want to be repair with the perfection, with the logic, then you can contact on the given number, and you can have the video, you can get the access of the video by contacting us. So if you really love this video, if you like this video, hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed our channel as of now, please subscribe it. Also hit the bell icon button so that you will get notification, because time to time we upload this types of information in our YouTube channel. So please keep on loving, keep on sharing, and keep on commenting. Thank you for watching this video.